Dress codes are a tradition at pretty much every school in the history of schools. If you want to go to school, by the way, if you want to hold a job or look dignified in public, you have to dress a certain way. It's probably worth teaching kids that lesson, but a Bay Area school district disagrees. Alameda Public Schools now say that students this year will be allowed to wear basically whatever they want. Ripped jeans, bare midriffs, pajamas. Administrators say it will improve fairness and fight sexism. Kathy Aru is founding publisher of Catalina Magazine. She is, of course, our liberal Sherpa, and she joins us tonight. Kathy, you for this?
Yeah, absolutely. I'm definitely for this. Aren't you?
So if there's, well, I don't know. I'm just trying to think it through.
Okay,
if there's
okay.
no dress code, mm-hmm. then why would, if dress codes are inherently sexist, then why are we allowed to tell kids to wear anything at all?
Well, they were saying the girls felt that they were being objectified with the dress code. That's what they were saying in this particular school district. That they were saying that the shorts were too short, that was a concern. They were being told that the uniforms would cover their body parts because the body parts are distracting, that a female's body is distracting. I mean, legs are legs. Why would a girl's leg be more distracting than a boy's leg? So by removing the...
I don't know if that's a sincere question or not, but let me just take it to the next stage and ask, why shouldn't girls be allowed to come to school topless?
Well, exactly. I mean, why are boys allowed on track teams to run topless and women are not allowed to be topless? In Europe, women are topless and there's no problem because women are not objectified as they are in this Puritan country of ours.
Obviously, you've never been to Europe, if you're saying that. Because the opposite is true, but whatever.
Well, when you go to the beaches in Europe, the women are topless in the beaches, but not here. Here
some,
it would be considered illegal.
But not typically in the classroom.
Not in the classroom
or at Starbucks.
Setting. No, not at,
right.
not at Starbucks.
Not
but in commercials,
there.
I mean, you would find people topless in commercials, mm-hmm. shampoo commercials in Europe. Yeah, because it's normal and it's not distracting. A woman's body is not only an object, it's not just sexual. Uh-huh. I mean, so who dictates why is a man's body okay?
Try that in downtown Rome and then call me, you know, get back to me, tell me how that works for you. But quickly, if there's no dress code, then would you have a problem with kids coming to school, Anglo kids in a sombrero or a kimono or in a seal fur Inuit outfit? Or would that be, is cultural appropriation the one exception to this?
Well, the thing is, if it distracts from the education, that's what the school's saying. If it distracts from education, they're not allowing it. If it doesn't distract from the education, then they're allowing it. So it's a democracy, actually. It would the school,
okay,
the
so
parents,
but just
students
to be clear,
will dictate what is okay and what's not okay.
Schools are not democracies. They're authoritarian institutions. But very quick, topless okay, sombrero not okay. Right?
Well, I mean, who's to say, though, that parts of the body, one part's okay,
okay,
one
we're
part's
out of time.
Okay.
I'm sorry. We're going to invite you back to explain that. Kathy Rue, great to see you.
Good to see you.
That's it for us tonight. Shannon Bream has an exclusive interview, by the way, with